Hello, today I'm going to show you how to put your video in a circle with a nice gradient border around it, like this in Davinci Resolve Studio 19. It could have some difference if you have another version of Davinci Resolve. It's going to be easy and I will show you step by step how to do it. After this, you will be able to say goodbye to the rectangle border and replace it with a beautiful border to elevate your project. So get ready to transform your video. First, I will place the footage I want to mask in a circle on the second track of the timeline, so it will be above the track of the background recording. Now we have two tracks. The track one will be the background and the track two will be the one with the circle mask. Now we have to synchronize this track. I will select both clips with a mouse, right click, and select auto align clip. In my case, I don't use time code, so I select waveform and I select the track with the better audio and click sync. Now the two videos should be aligned with the audio track as a reference. In this case, the audio of track 2 is better quality, so I will disable the audio on track 1 to remove the phase problem caused by two audio tracks at the same time. To do this, select the clip on track 1 and unlink them by selecting this icon. Then select only the audio clip on the track 1 and press D to disable it. This will mute the clip, but it is still available in case you need it. Just a note, when you sync clip like this, you need a good sound and you can align only one clip per track at a time. Also, if you have several clips, you should keep some space between clips because the auto-align process can override the clip on the left. Hey, before we continue, if you like my video, don't forget to subscribe, like, and add comment. This will help me to create more video for you. Thank you. Next, I will add a transform. So open the FX tab in the upper left, click on Open FX, and in the search bar, type transform. Select transform and drag it onto the video of the track 2. Or if you have selected the track before, you just double click on it. Next, open the inspector on the top right. Select effect, then open FX, then expand image adjustment and move completely to the right the edge rounding slider. Next, give a small edge softness, something like 0.1. One thing I like to do is to zoom in the circle to give some space for the next step of our circle. Something like 0.8 should be okay. Next, we will adjust our video in the circle. Click on the video and you can adjust the position the way you like it with the zoom, position or rotation. You can play the video to verify if the headshot is where you want it. Now to create our gradient border, first I will create a new fusion composition. From the media pool, right click and create a new fusion composition. Make it around maybe 10 minutes or the length of your clip, then drag it to the timeline. Next, I will mark an in and out point on top of the fusion composition. Next, I will use the 4-color gradient from the effect tab in generator. Select it and drag it on the right side of the window over the place on top. This will make it the length of the fusion composition. Next, right click on it and create a compound clip. You can name it a 4-color. Right click on the compound clip and select open in fusion page. We are ready to create our border in fusion. It's very easy. I will change the workspace to one window to give more space. Now click on media 1. I will add a transform to be able to adjust the size of the border. So press shift space bar, then write transform and select transform XF, or you can select the one from the toolbar. Select the transform and then setting and enable multiply by mask. The transform will give the option to resize the circle. Next, select the ellipse on the toolbar and connect it to the transform. Now we have a ball full of color. This is not what we want. Just select ellipse 1 and in the inspector, uncheck solid and change the border width to 0.02 or something else if you like. If you click in the box and drag left or right, you will have a more precise control. To remove the sharpness of the border, I set the soft edge to 0.008. Now I go to the edit page. You can press the Option and X on a Mac to clear the in and out point. In the inspector, I will be able to adjust the size of the ellipse to cover the edge of the circle. To finish, select the clip on video 3 and video 2, right click and create a new compound clip. Name it something like circle with border. Now in the inspector, you can resize the circle and change its position, flip it if you want. Also, if you select the transform in the bottom left of the main window, you will be able to move the circle easily. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. I see you in my next video. Bye bye.